Okay, so what if I were to tell you that Chinese hackers have just successfully hacked an iPhone 13 Pro running the latest fully patched version of iOS 15, also hacked Google Chrome, also hacked Windows 10?
So I'm guessing this is a competition you're referring to and not some kind of insane weekend out for Chinese APTs, right?
Well, it sort of is an insane weekend out actually for Chinese APTs, although these APTs are actually security researchers, some of the best hackers in China, indeed. And it's something that's called the, you're right, it's the Tianfu Cup, which is a competition, hacking competition, where specific targeted products and services are hacked live on stage. And this is came about a few years back when the Chinese government banned, they legislated against Chinese national hackers from taking part in foreign international hacking competitions like Pengtuan, which is probably the best known. It's Tianfu Cup has become known for actually some really big hacks, and this year was no exception. So we've got say the iPhone 13 Pro running the latest fully patched version of iOS 15 was hacked not once but twice. First one was a remote code exploitation execution exploit. Took 15 seconds. That won the team Kunlun Labs, who actually were the overall winners of the competition, $150,000. More importantly for me, there was another team, Team Pangu, that won $300,000, which is the biggest prize ever given in the Tianfu Cup. And that was for the same device, iPhone Pro 13, 13 Pro. And they jailbroke this. They got a proper jailbreak with a zero-click exploit in a matter of 1 or 2 seconds.
This is great. So is this all televised as such? Can people find it on YouTube if they want to watch the videos of the various platforms being hacked?
Yeah, the streams are there on YouTube. What you can't actually do is actually find out exactly what happened, because these are kept the details of the exploits, the details of the vulnerabilities are kept behind closed doors for the moment. They're fed out to the vendors. So Google Chrome was hacked a couple of times. In fact, one of those was a two-step chain exploit, which ended up giving you privilege escalation. At kernel level, which is particularly serious. Windows 10 was hacked 5 times, but we don't know exactly how this was done. So the vendors will be given all the details. They can then patch within 60 or 90 days before the exploits are made public. However, the twist here is being China, last couple of years, we've seen reports that whilst the vendors are notified, which is good, exploits, the same exploits using these same methods, actually happen in the wild by Chinese state actors for surveillance and espionage purposes before those patches are released to the public.
I've had this argument with people before where it's like, it's just a competition. Yeah, it's nothing serious. You're like, this is China. So China's banned Chinese white hat hackers from going abroad to competitions. They're competing in China, attacking Western technologies, getting prize money, and those exploits are then held within China. And I think I'm right in thinking there are some Chinese technologies that do quite well that prove surprisingly unhackable by the Chinese hackers operating in China on Chinese technologies, right? So I think really interesting, and I'm sure lots of great research comes out of it, but I think you have to have a sensibly cynical view of what's actually going on here, right?
Yeah, I mean, out of all the targets, I think there were 16 targets, and there were only three that managed to escape being hacked through the entire process. And that was a Synology network attached storage device, surprisingly, a Xiaomi Mi 11 smartphone, and an electric vehicle manufactured by a domestic Chinese manufacturer who they've not even told us who it was. But we know Chinese stuff actually escaped quite well.
Thank you.